Hello everyone, this is Suresh Kumar, Faculty of English, AVS College of Arts and Science. So in today's session, we will discuss about a poem written by William Blake. The title of the poem is A Poison Tree. So A Poison Tree is a poem written by William Blake. It was published in 1794 as part of his Songs of Experience. The poem represents repressed feelings of anger. The poem represents repressed feelings of anger of the narrator or the speaker or the poet. Okay, we can consider the speaker here as the narrator or the speaker or the poet. So the poem explores various themes like themes of indignation, revenge and fallen state of mankind. So in this poem, the speaker tells of how they fail to communicate their wrath. Okay, they fail to communicate their wrath. Wrath means anger, another word for anger, to their foe. Here foe means enemy, and how this continues to grow until it develops into poisonous hatred. Now let us have a look on the structure of the poem. The poem is a four stanza. Okay, it is a four stanza poem with a rhyming scheme A-B-A-B. Okay, sets of rhyming couplets with full rhyme make up each quatrain. Okay, right. The principal theme of the poem, the poison tree, is not anger itself, but the suppression of anger. Okay, it is not talking about anger, but it is talking what happens when you suppress your anger. Sometimes what we do, we don't reveal our anger. Okay, we hide it, but the anger is there inside us. So this is what the poem is going to show us. So the poem mainly deals about the suppression of anger, which leads to cultivation of anger. Okay, what do you mean by cultivation of anger? Actually, the word cultivation is somewhat related to agriculture. Okay, mainly agriculture, cultivating plants or cereals, something like that. Okay, right. So the poet is also trying to explain us, okay, the suppression of anger, relating it to a garden or the growth of a plant. Right. So this is the first stanza. Let me read out the first four lines of the stanza. Okay. So just listen. I was angry with my friend. So in the very first line, okay, see in the beginning of each line, we have the letter I. Okay, so it is the first person singular. The speaker is first person singular. There is only one speaker. Right, come to the lines of the poem. I was angry. Angry with whom? With my friend. Okay, I told my wrath. Again, wrath is anger. I told my wrath did end. So what happens in the first two lines, the poet says that the narrator was angry with his friend, but the narrator is able to, the speaker is able to share his feeling, emotion. Okay, what is the feeling of the speaker here? He is full of anger. Okay, and he shares his feeling with his friend that I am angry with you. Okay, and what happens when he shares what he feels towards him? The wrath gets end, it's over. Okay, but in the next two lines, again he says that I was angry with my foe. Foe means enemy. But here, the speaker, he doesn't share his feeling with the foe. Okay, so what is the result of it? I told it not. He doesn't share. So what happens? My wrath did grow. So the anger keeps on growing. Okay, the anger keeps on growing. Stanzas 2. Okay, look at the lines. And I watered it in fears, night and morning with my tears. And I sunned it with smiles and with soft, deceitful wiles. Okay, soft, deceitful wiles. So let us have a look on the rhyming scheme. Okay, fears, tears, smiles, wiles. In the beginning of the session, I told you when I was talking about the structure of the poem that the poem has a rhyming scheme of A, A, B, B. Okay, fears, tears, smiles, wiles. So in this stanza, the poet says that his anger was watered. Okay, he watered. How was it watered? It was watered with fears. Okay. Why here the poet is using the word fear? When he was with his friend, when he developed anger with his friend, he was able to communicate that this is what I am feeling towards you. But when it comes in the case of his foe, that is his enemy, okay, he doesn't want to reveal it. He doesn't want to show that what he feels towards him. Okay, night and morning. Morning here symbolizes day. Okay, night and day with my tears. So what happens? Okay, all his fears turns into tears, and I sunned it with my smile. Okay, so here we have to see how a plant grows. First we sow a seed, then we water it. Okay, the seed it becomes a sapling. Okay, slowly it germinates and it grows and it becomes a sapling. The sapling then it turns into a plant. The plant it grows up into a tree, and the tree it bears flowers and fruits. Okay, so this is the step by step stage of growing of a tree. Likewise, anger which was in the heart or mind of the poet towards his friend, it is ended when he shares it. Okay, but in the case of his enemy, that is foe, okay, he doesn't share, okay, he doesn't tell him. So what happens? It slowly keeps on growing like a plant. Third stanza, and it grew both day and night. Okay, so it was growing, multiplying day and night. So the anger is keep on adding. Okay, the amount of anger cannot be measured. It is an abstract. Okay, but you can just imagine that the anger keeps on multiplying. How? Day and night, and it bore an apple bright. Now the anger is compared to a tree. Okay, when you look at anger as a tree, the poet says that this tree is bearing fruit. Okay, and that fruit is called an apple. Okay, the fruit of anger is compared to apple. And how is it? It is very bright. And my foe beheld it shine. And the foe, the enemy of the speaker, he was attracted by its color and shine, appearance. Okay, and he knew that it was mine. And he knew that it was mine. His foe, he knew that the fruit, which is an output of the tree's growth. Okay, it was sown by the speaker. Right, this is the last stanza. And into my garden stole, when the night had wheeled the pole, in the morning glad I see my foe outstretched beneath the tree. Again, look at the rhyming. Okay, stole, pole, see, tree. So here the poet, he is trying to relate, okay, his anger with that to the biblical reference. Okay, so as we know that Adam and Eve were attracted to the apple of the forbidden tree, which was in the Garden of Eden. God had very clearly instructed that they should not consume him. Okay, but what happens? Satan, he enters into the Garden of Eden, and with his sweet words, he convinces Eve to eat it, and as a result, Adam also eat, and that fruit, that apple fruit, okay, it brings disaster in their lives, and they were later expelled from the heaven. Like Adam and Eve, the enemy of poet was attracted to the bright apple of the poet. Okay, like Satan offered the apple of forbidden tree to Adam and Eve, the enemy of the poet also took the apple, unaware the real intention and feeling. Okay, what is the real intention and feeling? What is the real intention and feeling? It is an output of wrath and anger. Thank you.